Hi friends, William Shakespeare is probably one of the most influential, popular and enigmatic playwrights in all of human history and is known to almost every single person on earth. He has given us several masterpieces such as Macbeth, Romeo and Juliet, Othello, The Merchant of Venice, Hamlet, The Tempest, As You Like It, The Taming of the Shrew, Antony and Cleopatra, and I can go on and on. This might seem like a shocker, but renowned personalities such as Mark Twain, Charlie Chaplin, Helen Keller, Henry James, Sigmund Freud, and many more believe that Shakespeare never actually existed, or at least never wrote any of the marvelous literature that is associated with him. So today, let's find out who really was Shakespeare. This whole argument about Shakespeare not being the real writer for his plays started with a man named Mr. James Wilmot. He was among the first ones to have raised this theory. He was researching about Shakespeare's life in order to write a biography on the literal wizard. But his findings astonished him. He realized that there were no proofs to state whether Shakespeare had even written a letter in his life or even read a book in his life. There was no paper trail or even documents proving if he ever went to school. In fact, we don't have a single Shakespearean play or poem written in his own handwriting. Shakespeare was born in an economically weak family, so it's close to impossible for him to have had access to information about the royal court, which was mentioned in several of his plays, or even know more than 20,000 words, as in everyday vocabulary, we only use about 3,000 words. He is known to have invented English words such as critique, elbow, dwindle, lonely, lackluster, swagger, green-eyed, and many more. But that's a difficult to digest fact, considering that many believe he might have never gone to college. In many written evidences, it seems like he wasn't even able to spell his own name. As you can see, the signatures on the screen were apparently made by Shakespeare. Do they really look like that of a learned master of literature? Even his death records don't mention the plethora of poems, plays, sonnets, etc. that he apparently wrote. Another fact is that we don't even know what Shakespeare actually looked like. This is called the Chandos portrait and was thought to have been Shakespeare's image. But recently it was revealed that there's no definitive proof to state this. There's another painting called the Cope portrait that was believed to have been Shakespeare's image. But later historians stated that this could have been an image of Sir Thomas Overbury, a poet born in 1581. You might be thinking, if it wasn't Shakespeare who wrote the plays, then who did? Let's shed light on some of the potential candidates for Shakespeare's writings. Sir Francis Bacon. Many believe it was Sir Francis Bacon, a famous scientist and philosopher, who wrote the plays and used the name Shakespeare as an alias. This was theorized based on some codes, ciphers and letters. Even his servant had mentioned that Sir Francis Bacon was known by a different name to the world. But the validity of this theory has been questioned by several critics. Edward de Vere. Edward de Vere was a 17th Earl of Oxford. He lived in Italy, which is a common location for many of the Shakespearean plays. He was a highly educated lawyer and was well versed with the happenings of the royal court, which were mentioned in many of Shakespeare's plays. People think he wrote these plays under Shakespeare's name as his plays had a political undertone and he didn't want it to be boycotted by the society. But there's a hole in this theory as Edward de Vere passed away in 1604 and Shakespeare's best works such as Macbeth and King Lear were published after 1604. A female writer. It's always way more difficult for a woman to flourish professionally even in the 21st century. So just imagine how much harder it would have been for women in Shakespeare's time. Even when the plays were enacted in the older days, no females were allowed to act in them. The male actors played the roles of females too. Some believe that the plays could have been written by a female author who was tired of the society's unfair treatment of women, as the plays portrayed women as headstrong and liberated. This was completely opposite of what most of the authors wrote in Shakespeare's time. Some examples of strong female characters would be Portia from Merchant of Venice. She's a character who has lost her father and has no brother. Yet she is known to discharge all her duties with great might and wisdom at par with a man. Juliet from Romeo and Juliet. Juliet is unlike any conservative female of her time. She rejects the proposal to marry the Count of Paris and chooses Romeo, which was a very bold move for that time. Rosalind from As You Like It. She is not an everyday shy girl. She disguises as a man throughout the play. She is also able to fit everyone around to match with her desires. Lady Macbeth from Macbeth. She plays the role of a strong villain and is even able to manipulate her husband and her rivals on her fingertips. Apart from the previously mentioned theories, some even believe Shakespeare was a pseudonym used by several authors. But whatever the case may be, we really cannot state what is the truth and what is not, as all of this took place years ago. There's no single concrete evidence to point at any single person. What do you think is the truth? If you like this video, please like, share, subscribe, click the bell icon, and I will see you next time. Thanks for watching.